Hi, Namaste, welcome to my channel Health, Wellness and Fun. My name is Pratyusha. In today's video, I'm going to share with you all how I managed my gestational diabetes and I was not on any medication for it and I managed it till the end with proper food and exercise. I'm going to share those tips and tricks with you guys. If you are pregnant or if you know anybody else who is pregnant and currently diagnosed with gestational diabetes, please share with this video with them. I'm sure it will be very helpful because when I was diagnosed with gestational diabetes, I searched a lot and researched a lot to find what can I follow, how can I manage it. There were many videos around food related or how to track it related, but there were very less videos or I didn't find any videos or any information on how I can manage it effectively. So I thought, why not make a video of it, and I have breezed through it with flying colors. So I thought, let me share with you all as well. Point number one, don't feel scared, panicked or guilty. You got this by following all the steps which your doctor tells you and also following certain exercise routine. You can keep this in control and don't feel guilty. You are not responsible for this diagnosis, so don't worry. When I was diagnosed with gestational diabetic, my doctor told me, you could be the fittest person sitting across in this room, but there will be many other conditions that will lead to gestational diabetics. It can be your family history or many other things, so don't ever blame yourself for this condition. Second point, when you are diagnosed with gestational diabetic, I think it is followed after a 3-hour glucose test, you will be diagnosed by gestational diabetic. After that, whatever your doctor tells you, that if they refer you to a dietitian or a diabetic special care, please follow up and go there diligently. Do not miss that. Do not think that you can do anything at home and manage it, because medical guidance is very much necessary in this case. And when you meet with your dietitian, that is when you will know what foods you can eat, what you should be avoiding, how much you should be eating during the day. For me, it was like 6 meals per day, 3 snacks and 3 full meals. And I also was given instruction on how many grams of carbs I should be eating per meal. Now coming to the next point, once you are diagnosed with gestational diabetes and you have met with your dietitian, ensure that when you eat meals, do not skip any meals or do not miss out on any meals. Please be sure you eat all the meals as said by your diabetic specialist, and also ensure that amount of carbs they recommend to be included into your diet. Do not get panicked and do not stop on any food. It takes a couple of weeks for you to realize which foods makes your numbers go up and which food will help you to keep it at lower. What worked for me is eating at same time every day and not missing out on any meal. And also including protein in my every meal has helped me immensely. For example, if I'm eating 1 cup of vegetable biryani, I will ensure that I have some protein along with it, maybe a boiled egg or maybe a bit of paneer or tofu, so that it will help me to balance it out. And also, you can also eat pizza. If you're eating pizza, if I eat 1 slice of cheese pizza, I ensure that I have 1 cup of salad as well with it. So it is always important to have your protein, carb and vegetables, a combined whole meal in your diet. Now coming to the most important point is walking after every meal. I swear by this principle and it has helped me immensely. My doctor told me that I should be testing after 1 hour after eating my food. That is, 1 hour after putting the first bite into my mouth, I should be testing for my blood sugar. So what I used to do is, I used to eat my breakfast, lunch or dinner. For breakfast, after I finished my breakfast, I used to walk for 20 to 25 minutes. And once it finishes 1 hour, I used to test my number. Always my numbers were really good. Also for lunch and dinner, I used to do the same thing. After my lunch, I used to finish my lunch within the first 10 minutes. I used to put alarm on my phone for next one hour, go for a walk, 40 minutes walk, come back, and when the alarm strikes that it's 1 hour, I used to test my numbers. Same thing for dinner. After dinner, I used to walk for 30-40 minutes. So after breakfast, you need to walk for 20-25 minutes. After lunch, walk for 40 minutes. After dinner, you walk for 30 minutes. This helps you to get very good numbers. You might not need any medication because your numbers will always be in control. And also, not only this, it will keep you active, and this has helped me immensely in post recovery as well. But I have a disclaimer here. There will be some scenarios, even after you eat right foods and do amount of walking, there might be still some cases where you might require a medication that you need to take for your gestational diabetes, and that is completely okay. Remember, this is all for your child, and so nothing to worry. But you can always put your best effort by eating the right food in right amounts and keeping yourself active. This will definitely help you. Give an example of how my intake of food used to be like. For breakfast, I used to have a protein shake or overnight oats or a toast of bread with peanut butter and half glass of milk. My mid-morning snack would be a small fruit plus cheese stick. This was same almost all the days. For lunch would be something like half cup of cooked rice or quinoa with 1 cup of sambar or dal and a side of vegetable or a paneer curry, and also 1 cup of Greek yogurt to give that protein factor. Sometimes when I don't make all this, I used to have something like 1 cup of vegetable biryani and a paneer dish. Evening snack used to be a medium-sized apple with peanut butter, or any medium-sized banana with a protein shake, or any medium-sized fruit with a protein. Dinner, most of the days it will be same as lunch, or some days I used to have a medium-sized uthapam with lots of veggies with it and a cup of Greek yogurt for the protein factor. If you eat a non-vegetarian, I think you can even go with chicken curry or maybe egg curry. You have many choices in non-vegetarian, and that would be my dinner. And after this, I used to walk again for 30 minutes, and my bedtime before bed snack would be a cup of ice cream with nuts on it. Yes, you can have ice cream. There are many brands that would suit you in your gestational diabetic, or you can make one at home as well. I will be sharing all that recipes with you. So I used to have a cup of ice cream or a fruit lolly or some dessert in my bedtime snack, but I would ensure I had protein. If I had a protein in my bedtime snack, my morning fasting numbers would always be great. So I have like a Greek yogurt with lots of fruits and nuts, or maybe a Greek yogurt, a frozen Greek yogurt, or an ice cream, or some kind of dessert in my bedtime snack. If you're interested to know any meal plans or meal ideas for gestational diabetes, please let me know. I've done lots of research on this, because when I was searching for myself, I didn't find any Indian vegetarian kind of meal plans that would help me. So I did all by trial and error method. I will be more than happy to help you. Please let me know if you want to know more of this gestational diabetic vegetarian meal plans. I will be happy to share with you. So if you want any meal plans on how to do it, please let me know. I'll be more than happy to show you recipes and drop the meal plans as well. Hope you like today's video. If you do, please click on the subscribe button. It really means a lot to me. Also like and share with your friends. Until we meet next time, stay safe, take care. Ta-da!